Hello everyone. Today, let's discuss about the concept of immunity. What are the types of immunity? What is the meaning of improving our immunity? And then later, let's try to understand the most relevant topic, that is the basic concepts of COVID plasma therapy and vaccine. I repeat myself, I will only concentrate on making you understand the basic concepts of these things using simple words, without using any technical words. I will not go into the details of each of these, nor I will concentrate on giving you some numbers. What is immunity? As the word says, it is a defense system of a body against any foreign substance or an outside substance. This foreign substance or the foreign attacker can be a bacteria, can be a virus, can be a fungus, it can even be dust or sometimes a transplanted body organ like a transplanted kidney. The role of immunity is to protect our body from these foreign attackers. Well, but sometimes this war between the defense mechanism and the foreign attacker may cause damage to our own body. I'll come to that later. There are two types of defense mechanisms. Non-specific or innate immunity and specific or adaptive immunity. Let's try to understand what these two things mean. Let's come to innate immunity first. All of us sneeze, right? We may sneeze because of a bacterial infection or a viral infection, or we may sneeze because of dust. But is it different in case of each of these? No, is there anything called bacterial sneeze, viral sneeze and dust-related sneeze? No, it's the same for all, right? So it is non-specific. The sneezing is just one simple example. This innate immunity also has many more components. You can see it in the list. This innate immunity does not differentiate between different foreign attackers. It just identifies them as foreign and then attacks against it and tries to neutralize it. While adaptive immunity is a specific immunity. After a certain amount of time or certain amount of days, body learns exactly about the attacking organism, makes plans and strategies as to how to tackle it, uses its raw material resources, and forms a very solid defense against that specific organism. So as you can imagine, this adaptive immunity or the specific immunity, which is generated after thorough planning, is way more effective than that specific organism than the previously discussed innate immunity, right? And one more thing about this adaptive or the specific immunity is that once the body prepares this specific defense system, that is the specific antibodies against an attacking organism, it remembers it for life. So the next time the same organism attacks the body again, body will be ready very quickly to tackle it. This is why you may have heard in case of some diseases that it affects the human beings only once. That is because when it affects again, the body is very early ready with its specific defense mechanism. Now you may have a question as to why do we sometimes keep getting the same infection again and again, right? So one of the main reasons for that is what is called as mutation in these organisms. That is, these organisms make some subtle changes in their structure, or in simple words, they mask their identity and pretend to be a different organism and then attack the body. Now this is not identified by our defense mechanism. That is, basically they deceive our immune system. Imagine if Chinese soldiers were to intrude into our country and our soldiers were to fight against them. Now imagine this war happening in a city like Delhi or Bangalore in the middle of the city. So if this happens in the middle of the city, there will also be a lot of collateral damage, right? That is, a lot of people may die, a lot of property may get destroyed, not just by the bullets and bombs of the Chinese soldiers, but also by the bullets and bombs of the Indian soldiers, of course unintentionally. Similarly, when a body defense mechanism, that is the immunity, fights against this attacking organism, there may be some amount of collateral damage to our own body. There are few substances which are released against these foreign attackers, which may act against our own cells and cause damage to our cells. One of the main substances is what is called as free radicals, causing oxidative stress. Now our body requires what are called as antioxidants, which will neutralize these free radicals and protect our body against these damages which may be caused because of the immune reactions. Now let's try to understand this whole concept of improving our immunity or immunity boosting in case of corona infection. Point number one, we don't know how efficient our innate immunity is. Is it functioning at its 100% efficiency or is it suboptimal because of various factors, maybe because of our unhealthy lifestyle? Point number two, do we have all the raw materials required for the production of specific immunity when we get the infection? Third, do we have enough amount of antioxidants which will neutralize the free radicals which may be formed because of the immune reaction against the infection? By immunity boosting, we mean to improve all these things. That is, make our innate immunity work at its 100% efficiency, provide all necessary raw materials, which are mainly proteins, for the production of antibodies or the specific immunity in case if we get corona. The third one, to provide our body with adequate number of antioxidants so that it can neutralize the free radicals which may be formed in case of fight between corona as well as our body immune system. I hope these things are clear to you. Now let's try to understand what is plasma therapy in case of corona. Take this example. Mr. A gets infected by corona. He has a decent innate immunity. That is why corona doesn't cause a lot of damage to him. And then after some time, his body makes a lot of planning, strategy, and then comes out with a very efficient specific immunity system, that is antibodies. Now even the antibodies are also good enough. He had very good amount of raw materials. Now what happens? They will neutralize the bacteria neutralize the virus completely. As a result, Mr. A wins the battle against corona. Now Mr. B gets infected with corona, but his innate immunity is not that good. He doesn't have enough of raw materials to make those specific immune systems, that is specific antibodies. Now in this case, corona can be dangerous. It may even kill him. Now we already know that the body of Mr. A had made necessary weapons or equipments which are required to fight against corona, right? So why can't we use those weapons in the body of Mr. B to fight against the same corona? Yes, we should be able to do, right? That is the concept of plasma therapy. That is, we provide a patient, say Mr. B, with the specific defense system which is already produced in the body of some other patient who has recovered. By plasma therapy, we are providing a patient with ready-made defense system in a quicker time. That is, the patient himself would have taken longer time. By then, who knows, the virus may have killed him. And he may or may not be able to produce an efficient defense system depending on his raw material availability. So we are producing a ready-made preparation of antibodies produced in the body of some other patient. Right then, do this for all corona patients. Why do we need a vaccine? Now understand, Mr. B got his antibodies from Mr. A. That is the ready-made source of specific immune system. Now we all know that we have done it for the betterment of Mr. B. But his body doesn't know that. It may not like it. It may consider those antibodies as foreign attackers and launch an attack against those antibodies, hence causing a lot of immune reaction and damaging Mr. B himself. So the best solution would be make every individual produce his own specific defense mechanism. Now how can this be possible? This is possible with a vaccine. What does vaccine do? Vaccine basically mimics the virus without having its harmful effects. So when the body is introduced with the vaccine, it makes all the planning and makes specific defense system against this vaccine. But that defense system will also work against the virus in case of an infection. Now this is how, with the help of vaccine, we will be able to have a preformed specific defense system for the body. All these forms of defense are weaker in elderly, children, HIV infected patients, cancer patients who are receiving chemotherapy, or if the immunity is purposely lowered in case of those patients who have undergone organ transplantation, etc. So these patients are at a higher risk. I'm not going to make a list of food or medicine that you must consume to improve your immunity or immunity boosters. I'm sure you have enough sources to get them. My only purpose was to make you understand this concept of immunity, and I hope you understood the same. In case if you have any query, feel free to comment. I hope you liked today's video. If so, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family. And for more health and wellness related videos, subscribe to this channel. Thank you.